Your home can either be the biggest blessing or the biggest burden. Are you making the most of it? Hey guys, welcome to episode 3 of The Rachel Cruz Show. This episode is gonna be so fun because we're gonna talk about home hacks for everyday living. And listen, I'm all about making your house a home, but let's be honest, any homeowners out there, you know how expensive it is, right? Not just buying a home, but maintaining and keeping up with a home. There's so many elements and so many parts. So I wanna break all that down for you and show you how you can do it wisely. So in this episode, we're gonna talk about some fun ways that you can save time and money when it comes to your home. We're going to decorate a room on a budget with my friend Landon, which if you know me, I'm a horrible decorator, so I'm so thankful she was here. And we're also gonna give you tips on buying and selling your home. So to get this episode going, one of the biggest ways that you can blow money is when it comes to home decorating. You guys, it stresses me out. Winston and I tried to decorate our living room and we brought in someone to help us, but it was like, curtains, how much do they cost? Are we sending a child to college? No, that's curtains. Like, it's crazy. It's crazy how expensive everything is. And you want everything to flow and be beautiful and, like, you know, beautiful couch and chairs and coffee table. I mean, all of it is just so expensive. And that's what I felt like. I felt like if you have a really nice room, like your living room, then you have to pay a ton of money for it. So I brought in an expert and I went over to Landon's house, and she's going to show us how you can decorate a room on a budget. I want to call you Living with Landon.
That's my first name is Living With.
And your last name is Landon. Okay, so make sure to check out your Instagram, which is Living with Landon,
yep,
and your website, your blog, because you have so many great tips on everything in life, but you're like, expertise, or the thing that I love about you, is your home findings.
Yes.
Things that you do with decorating a home.
It's my favorite thing to do.
It is. Yes. Decorating a
Absolutely.
Home.
Absolutely.
So when you walk into a store, what are like the first couple of things you look for when you're like, okay, I'm gonna redecorate a room?
Okay, these are three things I think about with everything I do, whether it be my clothes, decorating for a party. Yeah, put this down. You're getting inside.
I'm so inside
my head right now. And I think about, okay, what am I doing? I always think of two colors. I always think of a theme and just kind of like in my mind, what I'm wanting that to look like.
And are your colors mostly neutral, or do you do like a neutral and a pop, or like what's your—
Yes, for me,
anyone's style, I guess.
Anyone's style, but I could be doing my daughter's 12th birthday.
Yes.
And it was butterflies and purple, then I've got something to go on. So I think
go into
the store with a little bit of idea of what you're going for, but be open-minded.
Yes.
Because oftentimes you'll find something that it's like, it's a surprise. It's like the best find ever, and you weren't going there looking for it.
And it's like $15, which is the best
of the
best.
That's when you hear me like dancing down the aisle.
The Target dance.
Yes, 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 yes.
I love it.
So first things first, pillows.
Okay.
The most inexpensive way to add color to a room. If you're anything like me, I don't know what those people are called, but like a pillow hoarder, maybe? Is that a show on TLC? I don't know. But I love pillows. I love the way you can, you know, inexpensively change an entire room with a pop of color.
Yes.
I do not like to be married to color, so that therefore this is a great way to bring in color without spending.
So pillows, number
pillows,
one.
Pillows, number one.
So good to know.
Yes.
Okay.
Number two, another great way to bring in some color is just like a simple frame.
Yes.
Like this one was $9.99. Pretty, right? Goes with kind
that
of our theme.
Amazing.
So, you know, you can put pictures of your sweet family,
yes,
and add a little color there.
Yes.
Another really cool thing that I like to do is not stay necessarily in the home goods section, but go out into the kitchen section. I think using like these were just pretty serving bowls, but you know, next to each other on a console table would be amazing.
Beautiful.
And again, $5.99 and $2.99.
Yes.
I love a tray.
Okay.
Trays are huge. They're great to put on your coffee tables. I like to also bring in some like natural elements.
Yes.
So maybe it's a cool rock or geode or like a starfish.
Yes.
Then maybe pop a little bit of greenery and another little like a box or some sort of object. But this on a coffee table, it kind of keeps your look together.
And so easy.
Out.
And
yeah,
you can get a tray like for what? Like 10,
oh,
15
yeah, yeah,
bucks.
Anywhere. I love West Elm has really great ones. I like an acrylic tray if you don't
yes
want to make it something really light in your room. Not to take away, let's say, from like your ottoman or such. But these are really great, inexpensive ways.
So easy. Because yeah, all of this costs what? Probably like $75 altogether.
Maybe not even.
That, yeah.
Yeah.
Amazing. Yeah. Pop a color.
Pop a color.
You did it.
And I don't like a lot of color, so if I'm going to pick a color, it's blue.
It's blue.
Yes.
Hence your shirt.
Yeah.
It's blue. Okay. So we got—
Moving over.
I'd say orange.
Yeah. Coral, orange, salmon.
Coral. This goes with the starfish.
It does. This
we'll go with coral.
Okay.
Okay, so I do love this. I gravitate toward
flowers. You know what I do too, crazy enough? This is a really pretty color. Very yes. vibrant. It's very fresh. Very, very fresh. So a couple things that I like to also, getting back to popping color, is fresh floral. So this is just grocery store flowers.
Seriously.
Got to get a glass cube that yes. goes with everything. I mean, yes. an arrangement like this locally would probably be $75, which this cost me $12.99. Done.
Amazing. That's Easy. Why she's on.
That's why I'm me, right?
But okay. So this is good. Okay. Yeah. I'm feeling inspired.
Okay. And I like to kind of keep it in a little bit of a square setting, just something different, something, okay. you know, appealing to the eye.
Yes.
Back to the tray. Like this rock salt little, I like something that's interesting.
Okay, and see, and this is good for all of us out there that are really bad at decorating. Pick interesting pieces, because I would yes. walk past this in
and
an
like
aisle
this.
And be like, it's rock candy or a lava looking lamp back when I was in eighth grade. You know
exactly.
what I mean?
No, no, no.
Where I'm like, no, Rachel, like focus in on the cult. Like,
yeah, think about it.
And just step just out a little bit because
it's,
you saw
it's a conversation starter.
Yes.
So, and a little tea light goes in there. It's really pretty when it's lit
that's
up.
Good.
And let's see, $19.99. Good.
Okay, we'll branch out.
Okay. So now that we're staying in this warm pop of color, this whole coral thing,
yes.
I love metal.
Rose gold.
I was just going to say, do you know what this is?
I do. Rose
okay,
gold.
Rose gold. Good girl. Yes. Ding, ding, ding. You won the prize.
Landon 18.
You can take
Rachel
this home. This is your prize. I love introducing metal.
Okay.
I love it with different textures. Like, we got a whole, like, very natural thing and a texture, something interesting, and then
yes.
a metal. But yeah, this is a pretty little lantern.
Yeah.
I'll show you later how we're going to place this.
Okay.
So it'll be
perfect.
Really pretty.
Perfect.
And then lastly, I like symmetry.
Yes.
So when I find something, I'm like always looking like, oh, there's got to be another one. There's got to be another one. I found these two, and I have two tables behind me here that I always try to flank something on each side. So I like to keep it the same. $14.99. Aren't these cool? And they're actually a vase also.
Isn't that crazy? You guys.
You want to hold it?
Well, because I know. I'm like, I don't even want to touch it. And I don't want to, like, throw certain stores under the bus, but there's certain stores that this would sell for, like, $60. I mean, easily. Like,
and I found these.
And if I saw this in someone's home, you would have yeah. no idea what they pay.
Well, that's just it. I don't think people realize that you can pull off that look, and it can look very, very expensive, and you paid a fortune, but you did
and you
not have to.
Save that
no.
money.
Save
that
it.
Money.
Oh,
save I love
it for
it.
Something else, like a good purse.
And I see this.
I know. Again, with the pillow. But see, do you notice this one has a lot of texture, a little bit of beading? Like,
yes.
you could probably go to, I don't know, Anthropologie and be $75.
Yeah.
And this baby was, where is the tag?
$29.99. Marshalls, thank you very much.
There you go.
That's amazing.
So that's it. Just a couple little things to be on the lookout for when you're shopping
yes.
at these sorts of places. And
okay, well, this was perfect. This is like exactly what I was thinking.
Let's do this. Let's decorate.
Okay. So we'll take some pieces.
All right.
I'm
you grab the pillow.
Okay.
I'm going to grab the flowers.
Perfect.
Let's do it.
We did it.
You did it.
I did the picture frame.
I hope. Hey, listen, that's an important job.
I hope you did a great job.
I hope
you feel the weight of what I just did, my responsibility. For really, amazing, absolutely amazing. And I really am. I'm so encouraged to think, okay.
It's easy, right?
I can go in.
You watched the magic. It was like Bewitched.
Yes,
and
it was so great. And look at it. It's like a whole new room.
That's it.
Absolutely amazing. Well, thanks again.
You're so welcome.
I so appreciate it. And again, check out everything she's doing because she helps us live a great life on a budget, which is what I'm about. So I'll just go copy Living with Landon.
Okay, do it.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
Okay, you guys, how great was Landon? I loved just the advice of having neutral base and then a splash of color. And I learned something new. It's not always orange, it's coral. And I add that to my vocabulary, coral. So when I talk about homes, one of the questions I get all the time is about home insurance. And the topic of insurance in general can be a very intimidating one, right? There's auto insurance, there's life insurance, there's renter's insurance, there's home insurance. And so what I find is a lot of people are so intimidated by this that they just take whatever rate they've been given. And sometimes they pay it for a year, for 5 years, for 10 years. Oh no, is that you? Are you one of those people that's like, oh, I just love consistency. I love security. I'll just pay the same thing over and over again. It feels good to see the same money withdrawal from my checking account. No, 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 no. Step out of your comfort zone. Go and shop around. Because what I found is that people that use our endorsed local providers that's found on my website, rachelcruz.com, is saving on average $500, you guys. Because finding an independent agent to go and shop around at different companies is going to give you options and get you the best rate possible. And what's crazy is $500 is just the average. Carolyn wrote in to me and she said, Rachel, we did exactly what you suggested and contacted a private insurance agent. He saved us $1,500 a year. You guys, isn't that crazy? So after this episode, make sure to go to rachelcruz.com, click on the endorsed local provider, and talk to someone. Because again, you want to find someone in this industry that won't just save you money, but will talk with you, and someone that you trust that isn't in it for the money and just trying to get a commission, right? Someone that really wants to sit down and teach you about this stuff. And again, getting insurance is key because you want insurance in a time of crisis. So we want to do all this before the crisis happens. And speaking of crisis, Winston and I may have had a little crisis in the Cruz household recently. All right, crisis may have been a little dramatic, but in the moments of pregnancy hormones, it was a crisis. So the last kind of home project Winston and I went through was decorating the nursery for this little baby. And I kind of forgot about a nursery is like a whole new room, right? Like you go in and you're like, oh, we need a new crib, which may sound very obvious to some of you, but I kind of forgot about it. And so we needed a new crib because yes, we're keeping Amelia in our crib. Some of you moms may disagree with that, but we can talk about big girl beds later. But anyways, we had to get a changing table, a dresser. And the very first thing when I walked into this blank room is the walls. So that's what I saw. Our wall color is like this grayish, I say blue, Winston says more gray. I don't know if guys and girls have like different eyesight and they see different colors because I swear it was like, it's blue. It's a blue room and we're having a girl. And so I was like, well, we got to paint the room. I just assumed that was like known, right? And Winston said, well, Rachel, no, I really like the color. I think we could really be fine with just this color. I don't know if we need to paint it. Don't paint it. It's a blue room. Like we're having a little girl. And then I went even crazier and not just wanted to repaint, but the new trend now I hear is wallpaper. What? Bring back the 80s. Yeah, wallpaper. And so I thought, oh, we could get some really pretty wallpaper. And so I went, you know, on urbanoutfitters.com and all these great places. And I was like, there are so many cute wallpaper options. And then I started looking at the price and I thought, ugh. Yep, that's a little expensive, but that's okay. I mean, Winston, this baby needs wallpaper. And yes, she needs more swaddles. Yes, we have 18 from Amelia, but that doesn't matter. We need new ones, new patterns, patterns of swaddles and wallpaper. It's what she needs. And then I'm like, well, I can't put up wallpaper. I don't know how to do this. Winston's gonna probably try to YouTube it and put it up, but it stresses me out because if we're paying this much for wallpaper, just have a professional come in. So then I was like looking around, seeing how much it costs to pay for someone to come in, and it was just kind of getting out of hand. But I still really wanted it. Have you ever had that thing in life where you're like, it doesn't always make logical sense, but in my heart, I just know this is what we're supposed to do. And that's where we were at. I wanted wallpaper done by a professional. Winston wanted to keep the blue room. And so we went back and forth about this. Finally, we kind of came to this win-win agreement where I said, okay, I kind of know that it's not that smart to just buy a bunch of wallpaper, right, and like fill the room with it. So maybe we'll just do an accent wall and we'll keep the pink color. But I do want someone professional to come in. So we had a win-win situation. And you guys, oh my goodness, wallpaper is so fun. Even though I just did one wall, and I know you really can't see it and tell, but it's kind of shimmery and it has a really pretty design, and I'm not creative at all, so I don't even know what the design means. I know they're not flowers, but they're kind of swirly, classy things on it, and it's just really pretty. And so now that that is complete and the curtains are hung in the nursery, the crib is here, I look back at that situation, I think, okay, that was a great choice. We didn't go the extreme of the full wallpaper room, but then we didn't leave it where, you know, she's gonna have a blue room. No, no, no. It's a beautiful mixture of everything. And I'll be honest, I kind of think the room is gray now. And I think possibly the saddest part of this whole story is when we sell our home one day, I can't take that wallpaper with us, but I'll take the extra roll, do the new house. So, you know, this whole idea of buying and selling a home, it already has come in my mind, even though we're not necessarily on the market. So I wanted to bring in an expert to talk through some tips on selling your home and buying a new one. So when it comes to buying or selling your home, it can be a very daunting task. So because of that, I brought in an expert. Christy is here to help us out because in this process of buying or selling your home, you want someone in your life that you trust who's an expert in this area. So just like how we have endorsed local providers for insurance, we also have them for real estate. And Christy actually happens to be one of our endorsed local providers here in Nashville. So I begged her to come in and sit down with us and talk through some tips on buying and selling your home. So thanks so much for being here.
Thank you so much for having me.
Okay, so how long have you been a real estate agent?
11 years, which is really exciting, and 6 years as an ELP.
Okay, so tell me, what's your favorite part about being a real estate agent? If I were going in people's homes every day, I think that would be one of my favorite parts of like, okay, is this going to be a crazy looking home or is this going to be like a really cool home that I want to like copy all the stuff?
No. And it's hard every day for that. But for me, it's just helping people, you know, with one of the biggest investments they're probably going to make in their lifetime.
That's so great. So when it comes to buying a home, there are some really important tips for you guys to remember. Number one, make sure you get a 15-year fixed rate mortgage. You may look at the 30-year and be like, oh, wow, but my payment would be so much smaller. But listen, my goal for you is to be out of debt as quickly as possible, including your house. So a 15-year fixed rate mortgage really guarantees that you're going to pay it off quickly. That's not really industry standards though, right? A lot of people go for the 30-year.
Well, yeah, a lot of people go for the 30-year. And part of that is maybe they didn't have a plan initially when they go in for that consultation, you know? It's like when my husband tells me about going to the grocery store when I'm hungry. You know, he's like, that's not a good idea. And that's the same thing with buying a home. You know, you don't want to go into that lender appointment and not have any idea what plan you're going to do with your down payment or what type of loan you're going to get.
That's great.
So if you know, hey, I'm getting 15-year fixed mortgage, then that's going to help the lender a lot and you get to move to the next thing, like down payment. You know, like saying, hey, I know I want to put 10 to 20% down.
And that's right? A great percentage. I mean, that's a huge one. And that's really what I recommend people to do because you get to avoid PMI.
Your private mortgage insurance. And basically, it's the bank's way of saying, hey, if you don't pay for this, I need to just be collecting this money on the side to protect myself. And really, when you think about it, that 10% on a $200,000 home is $20,000.
Yes.
You know, and if you haven't thought about that ahead of time, when you're sitting down at a meeting, you know, you're like, oh my gosh, I didn't have $20,000 saved up. So it's very important to kind of do your research a little bit before.
So you know ahead of time.
I think
that's great. So a 15-year fixed rate mortgage, make sure you have 10 to 20% for your down payments. And then what else would you suggest?
So I would suggest, you know, that you pay no more than 25% of your take-home pay. And, you know, figuring out what that is for you.
Exactly. And no more than 25% of your take-home pay being your monthly payment. It may seem kind of conservative to some of you, but listen, we want your home to be a blessing, not a curse. That's what this whole episode is about. And when I talk to people and their mortgage payment is 50, 60% of their take-home pay, I'm like, no, that stresses me out. I'm like getting an ulcer thinking about that. I'm like, no. Back that down. Make sure that your home is a blessing, not a curse. And that mortgage payment is a huge, huge part of that. And when it comes to your monthly payment, make sure that you budget for it.
That's
right. This is key, people. Ding, ding, ding. Remember the budget. And my last tip is that I recommend that you find someone in your area that you trust. Someone like Christy, except you can't have her. She's here in Nashville. But finding someone that is a professional at this, they know what they're doing, and they have the heart of a teacher, not the heart of a salesman. So if you go to rachelcruz.com, you can just type in your zip code and find a real estate agent in your area that you trust. All right, those are some great tips when it comes to buying a home. But when it comes to selling your home, it kind of is a different ballgame in a sense.
Right.
And so what would you say is your number one advice to people when it comes to selling your home?
So I would say detach yourself from your home now, actually, because sometimes the sentiment that people have about the memories they have there, kind of leads into a little bit of confusion when you talk about getting ready to sell a home, you know? I had a story once where I had a client who had a chinchilla. His son had a chinchilla. And oh, I was terrified. I told him, I said, you know, I know this is, you know, his first pet, but some buyer walking into the house might be a little nervous about that. You know, so you have to just take yourself out of the equation and say, I'm moving.
That is so funny. Yes. And also use correct math when you're selling your home. It's amazing that so many people say, well, you know, I want a $350,000 house, so I'm going to try to sell my house for that and, you know, get the same amount. No. And like other things, don't trust the internet, people. It's amazing how people just go and they go to one of these real estate websites and they're like, oh, there's the value of my home. No, you want a person in your life, a real estate agent, to be able to walk through these numbers with you. So trust a person, not the internet, because I'm sure you see that a lot.
Absolutely. And you know, one of the values that real estate agents add to that equation is if you're using the internet, that person is not walking through your house, you know, when they tell you how much your home is worth. So when I go to meet and sit down with a seller, I'll often say like, hey, let me first walk through the house, you know, let me look, because I see lots of houses all the time. So they're comparing your house to something they just saw that sold or something that they know is on the market.
Because they know the market.
Absolutely. Yes. And I think that's a lot more valuable than just going to the internet when they're not considering any of those things.
That's great. And last but not least, Christy, what would you tell someone?
You gotta clean your house.
I'm shocked. What?
I know. And that is so difficult a lot of times because you hate to sit down with someone or walk in the door and you smell little fluffy before you see little
or
fluffy.
Or whiskers. Can we throw the cat people under the bus too? No, but it is true. I mean, a stench is not a good thing. It's not attractive when you're trying to sell your home.
No, so you want to clean it. You know, maybe you have to, you know, vacuum. Maybe you need to hire someone.
That is probably a good investment, actually, is to have someone come in and, like, professionally clean.
Yeah, I mean, you want it to be like a model home.
That's
what you're really going for. You're taking yourself out of the equation, and you're saying, how can I make my house like a model home? Because people love walking in model homes. It's the same idea.
Yes, it's so true. I'm bad at that because I'm not always good at looking past, like, paint color and carpet and smells, where my husband Winston, way more logical than I am. I know it's a shock to a lot of you, but he's probably more the logical one in the relationship. But he's always like, well, the house has good bones. I remember he kept saying that when we were looking at our first home. And I was like, wait, what? And so, yeah, because the cleanliness, all of that fogged me. And as a couple, especially if you're going in as a married couple and both of you have that feeling, then you can miss out on a great home because of that. So if you're selling your home, clean it up. I think that's great.
And another tip is, you know, when you're buying or selling a home, it's not exactly like the shows you see on HGTV.
Oh, break my heart a little bit, Christy, right? Joanna Gaines. My girl,
right?
Because we do love those shows. They're
absolutely
so fun.
Yes. We love those shows. But you know, when you're a buyer, maybe the house you're going in doesn't have granite countertops. Maybe it doesn't have an open floor plan. But like you mentioned, maybe it has good bones.
Yeah, and it doesn't have that one perfect wall we can knock out and make a huge closet for you. Like, it may not be there.
Right. And in addition, you know, maybe they're not contractors either, right?
So you're saying reality TV is not like reality, Christy? Is that what you're telling all of us?
Yes, unfortunately. And I'm sorry I had to be the one to break that news.
All of this just, again, reinforces this idea that you need a professional, someone to help you, whether it's running the math or telling you to put Fluffy away in the garage
just
for a little
temporary
bit. Find someone that you trust. And again, our endorsed local providers are there for you. And you can also go to rachelcruz.com, sign up for my newsletter, because you may actually not even need to be selling your home. We're talking about that. But I have a checklist on figuring out, is this a good financial decision for you? Should you or should you not sell your home? Well, thanks, Christy,
for
coming in and talking about this. Such an important topic, some great information that I hope some of you guys learned some things, and thanks again. You know what they say, home is where the heart is. So you want to make sure your heart is in the right spot. So whether it's buying or selling your home or redecorating, all those things are so great. But remember, you're doing this for you and your family, not for everyone else. Your motivation has to be when you walk in the door that you find contentment and peace in your home. And you can do it on a budget. So thanks you guys so much for watching. This was such a great episode. Thanks for tuning in. Love seeing your questions and your comments, and I can't wait to see you soon. We'll cut that. Sorry, that was, sorry. And you get a stench.
That's not a word.
Stench. Stench. Did I not say stench?
Which one was
mine?
Mine. Right.